Hey everyone, welcome to this little live stream. This is the real concert. You have seen already two sound checks from me. But now I will not switch off the live stream again. First people are watching. Hey everyone. So I have two cameras here. I have to watch at my laptop here to see your comments. Would be glad to have a little chat in between. And there's the main camera, of course. Some more people arriving. Welcome. So this is my living room in Dresden, Germany. And it's 10 p.m. already, so quite late for a Monday. But I'm sure you're watching from all over the world. And I'm very curious from where you're actually watching. So please leave a comment where you are right now. Meanwhile, I play you the first song. And this is an older one, which is actually a duo piece. I will probably tell more about that later. But it's called A Magical Place. Thank you. Thanks a lot. That was called A Magical Place, and I wrote this as a solo guitar piece, and now it's actually a duo piece. I'm playing together with a wonderful violin player from Denmark called Bjarke Felgren, and we made an album together and now play some tours normally if there's no COVID. And if we're able to rehearse right now, the borders are closed, but yeah, so there's a video on YouTube where you can actually watch the duo version if you're interested. And let me just check your comments. Costa Rica, wow, welcome to the stream. France, all over the world, good to see you. Chris, that's a great ear. That's exactly the tuning. This is actually my favorite tuning, and I made it up. Probably I didn't made it up, but I made it up for myself when I was rehearsing with Bjarke. And since the violin is tuned in fifths, I tried to tune the bass strings of the guitar C G D, so like a cello, and. When I did that, the two instruments were just linked together. It worked very well. And then I figured out that it's also quite nice for solo guitar because I have the low C. So let me play a second one. By the way, if you have any questions, like Chris, feel free to ask in the comments. I'm happy to chat with you and answer some questions in between. I will mainly play some older songs today. I wrote a lot of new pieces, like I think 26 new pieces during the lockdown. But most of them are only existing on paper yet, and I cannot really play them. But let me show you one new one. It doesn't have a title yet. But I know already that it's dedicated to my grandpa. My grandpa passed away when he was 26 years old. And since I was 26, I had the idea in my mind, I have to write him a song. And last Christmas 2019, I found an old photograph of him where he was playing a guitar. And I had no idea that he played guitar. So then I really thought the next composition has to be for him. So this one is for my grandpa and doesn't have a title, but let's see if I at least remember the notes for you. Thank you. Thank you very much. So that was a brand new piece. Daniel, so everyone, you see Daniel Stark in the comments. He's a fantastic luthier from Germany. So because he's already talking about that, he wonders how the ToneWoodAmp would sound with other instruments. I will show you the ToneWoodAmp. It's attached to the back of my guitar. I hope you can see it. So I actually have this little magnet in most of my guitars, so I can just attach it to any guitar I want. And the reverb you're hearing, in case you didn't know yet, it's just coming out of the sound hole. I don't have any effect boxes here at all. It's just this little thing on the back. So it's wonderful to just play on the sofa, outside, at the beach, wherever you want, and have this big reverb or even other effects like a delay or something. And it's very inspiring actually for composing, because this room, this is my living room, as I said earlier, it sounds very, very dry and not really inspiring. So this ToneWoodAmp helps a lot when I compose. So when I compose, I use it a lot, and especially when I compose pieces like the ones I just played, some ballads, some quiet stuff, it's really nice to have some more sustain and room and make this sound like a little church. I really enjoy it. So yeah, in case you're still looking for Christmas presents and you have some guitar players in your family, I might have an idea. Well, with nylon strings, I found when I use it on my nylon string, I place it a bit more to the middle of the guitar. Maybe that's a coincidence, maybe that's just my guitar. So at the steel string I have it more a little bit more like here, and for the nylon string it sounds warmer and more natural when I have it a bit more in the middle, but it works well, no problems with it. So let me play another old piece. Actually, probably the oldest piece I'm still playing in concerts from time to time. And this is a fast one where I normally don't even need any reverb. So let's see how that works with a ToneWoodAmp. But this one is called On the Run. Hey Bernd, thanks for staying up. Good to see some friends. Thank you. Thanks a lot. Sorry, neighbors. Sorry, ToneWoodAmp. But after the two ballads, I had to play some notes. Now I'm warm for sure. So thank you so much to the ToneWoodAmp people for doing this. Like, this is a little video series. It's not only me today. It's like every week one artist, and the people from ToneWoodAmp share a one day revenue every week with one of their artists who play a little live concert. And I'm very lucky it's me today. So thanks, Eleni. Thanks, Ofer. Thanks, Dave. Thanks, everyone else. So I really hope you also support or can support ToneWoodAmp with buying one of these magical little boxes. Short ballad for you. If you have any questions, feel free to post them in the comments after the piece. I might be answering a few. So this is my personal Christmas song. I wrote two Christmas songs in my life, one for solo guitar, and this one I wrote it on the train one day before Christmas a few years ago. I live in Dresden in the east of Germany, but I'm originally from the northwest of Germany, so it's like 7 hours by train to go home. And 2015, I had quite a busy year. I was still studying and I had a lot of exams and a lot of concerts and I was teaching, and after that I didn't visit home so much in that year. So for Christmas it was really a special feeling to come home. And I had some space in the train for myself, and I had 7 hours time. So normally it takes me about 1 year to write a piece, but this one took exactly 7 hours. And it's called Homeland. Hope you enjoy. Thank you. Thank you very much. So that was called Homeland. Just watching the comments, see what you write. Oh, thank you, Jim. Thank you so much. Oh, that's a good question, Chris. Actually, my influences are very different. I try to not limit myself in any way. So it can be classical guitar music, can be a hiking tour through the vineyards or something. But I started with classical guitar. Then I had a time of 4 years where I played only steel string fingerstyle guitar before my studies. And then actually in the studies, I had some jazz and a little bit flamenco-ish lessons on top and composing lessons as well. And everything came together again. And that was like a good recipe to find something original, to have these many different roots, basically. So that's my guitar influence. But when I think about my influences for my compositions nowadays, it doesn't come from guitar music, because I have this idea of I don't want to copy anything that's already there on guitar, so I mostly listen to bigger projects, like not solo instruments, like bands or string quartets or anything, basically, and just try to find inspiration there and transfer to the guitar. And and another influence is, of course, playing with other people. Like, I have a duo with another guitar player called Philipp Wiechert. I have the duo I mentioned with Bjarke Felgren. So those musicians, of course, also change my way of playing a lot. Maybe you see in the description of the video that I have a little tip jar, so in case you're interested, leaving a little tip, there's the link. You don't have to, of course, you can also buy a Tonewood amp. But because Chris mentioned jazz influences, play you a jazz standard, and this is my little arrangement of a song from Dizzy Gillespie, and it's called A Night in Tunisia. Thank you. very much. Night in Tunisia. Actually, I'm using the hall reverb setting in my ToneWood amp. This one sounds just very big and beautiful, especially on the nylon string. And I hope the reverb comes across well, so you can hopefully hear it. So this is just coming from the sound hole. Let me tune to another tuning again. Back to the first one. It's like in a real concert that you also have to hear a lot of tuning. Today, the whole day, I was composing something new, and it was something very percussive, so I didn't really have to tune my guitar. I was just drumming, but now I have to. Play one more new song for you, which will be on the next album. I will record my next album somewhere in the first half of the coming year. The songs are almost finished. I still have to practice them and still have to finish two pieces, I think. Record. Until then, there are two old records. You can check them out on my website. And or listen to them on Spotify, iTunes, wherever you want. But this one is not recorded yet, and this is a piece I wrote when I was in Denmark after I recorded my duo album with Bjarke Fellgren, and I was sitting in his garden, and I was just jamming, and suddenly this melody appeared, which sounded like really calm and also a bit Scandinavian, but the song didn't have a title for a very long time, and I was talking to a good friend from Japan. Maybe you know him. His name is Okapi. He's a fantastic guitar player. And I was explaining what the song was about, because when I wrote it, I saw the evening sun going down behind the trees. And maybe you know it, when the sun shines through the trees, you see sunbeams. And it looks like really beautiful. But it's a lot of information if you want to create a song title out of it, like the evening sun hides behind the trees and you see single sunbeams and everything is very nice. That's not a song title. So I was talking to Okapi and he said, "That's no problem, Soenke. We have a word for that in Japanese. And this word is komorebi." So komorebi means the sun hides behind the trees and everything else. So this is my little Scandinavian song with a Japanese title, written by a German. Thank you. Thanks a lot. That was called Como Rebi and will be part of the new album next year. So I have one more piece prepared for you. So I still want to mention one more time a big thank you to Helene, Ofer, Dave, and all the people from ToneWoodAmp for giving me this opportunity to play for you tonight, or this afternoon, wherever you are. It's a lot of fun, and it's good to see you writing in the comments, and it feels almost like having a, like, you are a real audience, of course, but almost like having you in front of me. I'm just playing into this little webcam. There's a ToneWoodAmp question. I'm sure Dave will answer. Oh, thanks, Janet. Good to see you. So the last piece, before you all go to the ToneWoodAmp page and buy a ToneWoodAmp or check out my tip jar, who knows, is the title track of my solo album, which is still the newest for now. And this one, because I know there are a lot of guitar players in the comments, I have to play this piece. It gets requested a lot. Because the inspiration for this piece was a technical exercise for guitar players. I was actually playing, I don't even remember which piece it actually was in my studies. I was playing like a really difficult classical guitar piece, and my left hand was just not strong enough to play like the whole 7 minutes. I was just exhausted after five or something. So I needed an exercise to strengthen my left hand, and I found this exercise where you actually play a little motif just with only your left hand, tapping. So I made this little motif and it sounded like this. And I played it like over and over. Fingers, all the stuff you do when you study. And I remember it was also shortly before Christmas, so I was at my parents' place, and after 2 days I was definitely the only one in the house who still thought that was beautiful. And I thought maybe if some melodies would appear at the same time or some percussion, maybe it will be a song at the end. And 1.5 years later, I had it, it was finished. So, because this little line, you will find it always, like almost everywhere in the whole piece. The piece is called Perpetuum Mobile, so perpetual motion. But don't worry, I will stop after 4 minutes. So thank you so much for listening. Also to everyone who will still watch it later. It was a lot of fun to play for you, and I'm already saying sorry to my neighbors for the next piece. And I look forward to see you maybe on a real stage, a real concert hall again next year. This is a lot of fun, but playing on a real stage is even more fun. So see you on the road, hopefully. Thank you so much, Bernd. Thanks, everyone. Perpetuum mobile. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching, and hope to see you another time, maybe at a real concert. Thanks everyone at ToneWoodAmp for making this possible, and see you very soon. Bye bye.